So, have you solved that problem which I have given to you in the last class? I have said you one problem which has came in the RTU paper. Has anyone solved it? Please tell, has anyone solved that problem? Aishwarya, Amisa, did you solve it?
Yes, sir.
So what was the outcome? What was the answer you have received?
C dot H H to the transpose, I have not solved it. Another question I have solved.
Okay, which question you have solved it?
Sir, second question which you gave, G is equals to 100.
So what was the answer you are getting there?
Sir, the correct code will be 1000 1 5 times 0 1
One triple zero
1 5 times 0.
and one.
Yeah,
Okay. Amisa, did you solve it?
it is the answer of second question, sir.
Okay. Amisa? Amisa, can you hear me? No, sir. Abhichal, did you solve it? Abhichal? No. Are you see?
No,
Are you see?
sir.
Okay, Gunjan.
No, sir.
Harshita. Harshita.
Yes, sir.
Did you solve that question?
सर सॉल्व किया है पर क्वेश्चन लास्ट में आंसर करेक्ट नहीं है.
क्या सॉल्व किया? क्या आंसर करेक्ट नहीं है? आपको कैसे पता है कि आंसर करेक्ट नहीं आया?
सर बीच में थोड़ी प्रॉब्लम हो गई कोड में.
नहीं, ऐसा मत बोलो हाँ या ना। आपने सॉल्व नहीं किया, एक्सक्यूज, ऐसा बहाना नहीं बनाना अपने को। हेमू? हेमू?
ट्राई तो किया है. नो सर.
नो। किरण? किरण, डिड यू सॉल्व इट? किरण परासर?
यस सर. कौन सा वाला?
कौन सा वाला जो प्रॉब्लम दिया था
यस
होमवर्क
सर.
में? हाँ, क्या आया फर्स्ट वाला? फर्स्ट वाले वेरीफाई कर पाए आप? सी एस ट्रांसपोज इक्वल टू जीरो।
यस सर. हेलो.
हाँ, वेरीफाई कर दिया आप सी एस ट्रांसपोज इक्वल टू जीरो? हाँ, आई कैन हियर यू किरण। किरण, डिड यू वेरीफाई दैट सी एस ट्रांसपोज इक्वल टू जीरो इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट?
हेलो.
हाँ, आई कैन हियर यू किरण, बी क्विक।
हेलो, माय वॉइस इज क्लियर?
या योर वॉइस इज क्लियर एंड ऑडिबल टू, सो प्लीज बी फास्ट। कोमल, डिड यू सॉल्व दैट? कोमल? कोमल, हैव यू सॉल्व इट? कोमल, कैन यू हियर मी? सुमन, कैन यू हियर मी? सुमन, डिड यू सॉल्व इट? सुमन? सुमन, डिड यू सॉल्व इट? सो एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू ऑल और नॉट?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
सो कोमल एंड सुमन, डिड यू सॉल्व दैट प्रॉब्लम व्हिच आई हैव गिवन टू यू? ओके, आई थिंक दे आर नॉट इन द अदर एंड, सो दे माइट बी डूइंग सम अदर वर्क। आई हैव ऑडियो। सो कोमल, कैन यू राइट देयर, डिड यू सॉल्व दैट प्रॉब्लम? ओके, सुमन, आर यू ऑडिबल?
in some other work. I will join after 5 minutes.
No, no, also one you can do
No, no,
that.
also one you can
You
do that on it.
do that other work and join in the next
Do that other
class.
work and join in the next class.
Just 5 minutes. I need 5 minutes. Sorry, sir.
So we have done with the linear block codes, and you can see you have 2 or 3 days of the time and you have not utilized it. So my main motive of the giving the problem is so I have to see how much you are putting your effort. तो ऐसा नहीं है कि आप ऐसा आपको लग रहा है कि आता है सब आता है और मतलब कर लेंगे पेपर में, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. फिर चीजें अभी साइक्लिक कोड पढ़ेंगे, सो देर आर मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ साइक्लिक कोड्स आर देयर, सो यू विल गेट कंफ्यूज. तो आपका ही दिक्कत आपको ही होगा. मेरा मुझे कोई नुकसान नहीं है क्योंकि सो व्हाट आई वांटेड इफ आई एम गिविंग माय एफर्ट सो यू शुड आल्सो गिव इट्स फॉर योर बेनिफिट आल्सो. सो देर आर मेनी पीपल हु आर नॉट टेकिंग क्लासेस, मेनी पीपल आर देयर हु आर टेकिंग द क्लासेस फ्रॉम द पीपीटीज एंड ऑल. सो दे आर दिस इज जस्ट अ टाइम पास. सो आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू डू टाइम पास. एक्चुअली योर पेरेंट्स आर गिविंग 40,000 रुपीज टू द कॉलेज, सो यूटिलाइज दैट. सो इट्स हाई टाइम बिकॉज यू आर इन थर्ड ईयर एंड आफ्टर दैट यू आर गोइंग टू द फाइनल ईयर. सो दे विल आस्क यू फॉर द जॉब एंड नॉट ओनली योर पेरेंट्स, मेनी मेनी पर्सन, योर रिलेटिव, मेनी मेनी पीपल विल आस्क यू. सो इफ यू विल नॉट पुट योर एफर्ट्स नाउ नोबडी विल गिव यू जॉब. ऐसा दिस इज अ मिथ दैट यू आर इन ए आई टी डिपार्टमेंट यू विल गेट अ जॉब. चलो मिल भी जाएगा, कितने का मिलेगा? 3 लैक्स. वॉट यू विल डू इन टूडे सिनारियो, वॉट दैट 3 लैक विल मैटर विथ यू. सो अगर अच्छा जॉब करना है तो एफर्ट्स लगाना पड़ेगा. ऐसा नहीं है कोई भी सब्जेक्ट पढ़ रहे हैं तो उसमें एफर्ट्स लगाइए. हम लोग भी ऐसा नहीं, हम लोग भी मेहनत कर रहे हैं, पढ़ा रहे हैं, तो आप भी थोड़ा मेहनत कीजिए. नहीं तो ऐसा बहुत लोग हैं जो क्लासेस नहीं ले रहे हैं, बहुत लोग हैं जो टाइम पास कर रहे हैं. हम भी कर सकते हैं ऐसा, उसमें कोई बड़ा बात थोड़ी ना. पैसा तो हमको भी मिल ही रहा है. सो ऑल आई वॉन्टेड यू ऑल्सो पुट योर एफर्ट बिकॉज इट्स फॉर योर बेनिफिट ऑल्सो ओनली. एंड योर पेरेंट्स बहुत पैसा खर्चा कर रहे हैं. आप देखो घर बैठे हुए हो, क्लासेस कैसे कैसे चल रहा है, उसका भी पैसा लिया जा रहा है. ऐसा थोड़ी ना कॉलेज पैसा नहीं ले रहा है कि नहीं हम पैसा नहीं लेंगे, आपके बच्चे पढ़े नहीं है. कॉलेज पैसा लेगा, कॉलेज अपना काम करेगा, तो आपको भी अपना काम करना है. एक ही काम तो है, दिन भर में 2 लेक्चर अटेंड करना है और 2 दिन का समय था एक क्वेश्चन लगाना है. तो मुझे आंसर से मतलब नहीं था, आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू सी हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर पुटिंग योर एफर्ट्स. सो इससे ही मतलब था, ताकि इतना बिजी शेड्यूल भी नहीं है ना, पूरा टाइम तो फ्री है हम लोग. कितना टाइम तो मोबाइल में ही लगे रहते हैं, तो एक काम मोबाइल से ही पढ़ भी लेते, कोई दिक्कत नहीं था. एक सवाल ही तो दिया था. चलो लेट्स मूव टू साइक्लिक कोड्स. वी हैव डन विद द लिनियर ब्लॉक कोड्स. सो एक्चुअली साइक्लिक कोड्स एंड ब्लॉक कोड्स आर मीन्स सिमिलर एंड यू विल कन्वोल्यूशन कोड इज डिफरेंट. सो इन द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द क्लासेस आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट दिस ऑल डिपेंड्स ऑन द वैल्यू ऑफ द के. So basically, if I have to write cyclic code definition, so cyclic code will follow two things. One is linearity. I'll tell you what is the linearity. So if it will satisfy the two thing, then it will be called as cyclic code. So first thing which it needed to satisfy is linearity, and second thing is shifting property. You might be aware of linearity and shifting property, so I'll tell you. So if this two thing will satisfied, then only the code will be known as cyclic codes. So I'll write a one line definition for you. Somebody will ask you a cyclic code. I'll write like this: a n comma k. So we are talking about n comma k means n is the code length and k is the message bit. N comma k is known as cyclic code, known as cyclic code when it follows these two things. So first one is linearity and second one is shifting property. So if it will satisfy these two property, then only it will be known as cyclic code. So n comma k, it might be 6,3, 7,3, 8,3, anything. So anything, if this code will follow these two properties, then it will be known as cyclic codes. So I will tell you the example, the one I'll take one problem or example for you so that you can know what is cyclic codes. So let me write a problem for you. Suppose a code is given like this. Suppose the code is given like this. Okay, so code is given like this 0 0 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 1. So if somebody will ask you, is it a cyclic code? So problem it will be like this: is it a cyclic code? So I have told you, first of all, it will follow, it should follow linearity. So what is linearity basically? So basically linearity means if you will add this two code or this two code or this two code or this two code, so the outcome of this two code will be in this box only. It means that if suppose I am taking, so if अगर 0000 को इनसे ऐड करोगे तो वही वैल्यू आएगी, कोई मतलब नहीं. सो सपोज आई एम टेकिंग 0110 एंड आई एम एडिंग दिस 1001, सो इट विल बी एक्सोर ऑपरेशन. सो वी आर ऑल अवेयर ऑफ एक्सोर ऑपरेशन. सो 10 इट विल बी 1, 10 इट विल बी 1, 10 इट विल बी 1 एंड 10 इट विल बी 1. सो सी वन दिस 100 विल बी इज देयर इन द बॉक्स, सो इट इज गुड, वी आर गुड टू गो. सो नाउ सेकंड थिंग, सेकंड व्हाट आई हैव टू ऐड 0110 then 1111, so it will come 1001. So it is there. So now this is following a linearity thing, it is following the linearity. So now we are moving to the shifting property. So we are going to check, is it following the shifting property or not. So are you getting it what I have done here? So should I move to shifting?
Yes sir.
So let's move to shifting. So I'll tell you what is basically shifting is. So there is no need to do shifting for this zero. Whatever you will do, zero same thing will come because 40 will be there. For this shifting, I'll tell you. So how to do shifting property? So if you will do one bit shifting, so this will come here, this will come here, this will come here. So let's light in a good way. So let's move light like this. So if I have to do shifting for this, this will come one position here, this will other position, this will other position, and that will go here. So what I can write here, 0011. So you can see 0011 is not in the box. So it is not following the shifting property. So are you able to see what I've done here? Should I tell one more time how I've done the shifting? You don't have to do anything. Whatever the right code is there, you have to shift one here. So we are basically shifting from right to left. So I have shifted this zero there. So if you can see, for 1001, so this will move one left, 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 and this will come right. So what I'll write, what I can write, 1100. So you can see this is also not in the box. So it's not necessary to check those two codes. If one is not satisfying the shifting property, so it is not a cyclic code. So is it clear? Is this problem is clear? I'll go for one more problem. It's not an issue. Is this clear? So actually it is not a cyclic code because it is not following the linearity and shifting property. It is following the linearity property, but it is not following the shifting property. It has to follow both property to be a cyclic code. So let me go for a second problem, so things will be more clear to you. So I'll write one more problem for you. So the other problem is 0000 0101 1010 and 1111. So this is other problem. So first of all, we will check for linearity. So let me check the linearity. So no need to add this because whatever you will add, you will get the same value. So I'm adding this 0101 1010. So if I'll take do XOR operation, what I'll get here? 1111. So it is there in the box, so no need to worry, we should go ahead. So I'll take one more code, this will be 0101, and if I'm adding with 1111, so I'll get here 0. If I'll add 1, this will be 1, this will be 0, this will be 1. So it is also there, so no need to add. If you'll add all those three others also, so we'll get the same, you'll get in the box. So you just try there. So now I'm moving to the shifting property. So it is following the linearity. It is following the condition for the linearity. So I'm moving for shifting. So if I have to move this code, so one bit it will move here, one bit will move here, and this will come this side. So what I'll get here? 1010. So it is there. You can see it is there here. Now if I have to move 1010 1010, so I have to just move there. So what I'll get? 0101. So it is also there. So this code is known as, so one mark problem will come like this. Check whether this code is cyclic or not. So by looking this, we can write here that these codes are following linearity and shifting. So these codes are cyclic codes. So is this clear? So two mark question will come in your paper like this. Verify these codes are cyclic or not. So you have to just follow two properties, linearity and shifting. If they are able to satisfy this, these codes are cyclic. So now I'm moving to the other parts. So what
sir,
are
when we are
what I can't hear one more time.
So when we are doing the right shift for 0101, we will not get 0101.
No, for 0101, you're telling for this.
Yes, sir.
0101. So this will come here. This will go like this. What you will get? 1010. So you are getting this now in this box.
When we do right shift, we don't place it over again.
What? You see, I can't.
Are we doing right shift operation?
We are just shifting one bit to the right. We are just shifting one bit to the right, every code.
But sir, when we shift one bit to the right, then it will not come to the first place, I guess.
Which will not come to the first place?
But the last bit will not come to the most significant bit now.
You are talking about this?
Yes, sir.
So how, what it will come? What will be the answer? Tell me. What will be the right shift for this code? Are you see what will be your answer for this code? One bit right shift code. What you are getting? Are you see, am I audible? There might be some network issue. So, am I audible to you all? Is this, are you? Are we good to continue? So I think there was some connectivity issue. Okay, so if there is any problem in right shifting, you just follow this, what I'm trying to tell you. So don't do anything else. Just shift this code here. Sorry, just shift this right, outmost right code to left side of this zero. So whatever you will get here 1010. So don't get confused. What I've told you, just follow this thing. You will not. One second, I should add IOC. I see I've lost your connection issue in between. So I'll tell you one more time. But don't not know it. What IOC, first tell me your answer. What is your answer? One bit right shift for this code. So after this, I will tell you. IOC, what is your answer you are getting when you will do one bit right shift for this code?
Sir, it is 0010.
0010. How are you see?
Because sir, whenever we do right shift operation, the last bit will be gone. It won't be inserted at the most significant bit now.
Okay, right bit will be gone, and where it will be gone?
It is gone like suppose I have a number 8 denoted as 1000, right?
Okay.
So, if I do right shift operation.
So, what I've understand, listen. What I've understand that you're telling that we need to replace this number, and instead of this number, you are adding zero here.
We are shifting all the bits one position to the right now.
We are not shifting all the bit one position to the right.
Then.
We are just shifting this bit one position to the right. This bit, and the most right bit is coming in this position. So we are not doing here. So basically, I'll tell you like this. So you will get more clarity. So suppose this 1010 is there. This. So you don't need, if you are getting confused, don't need to do anything else. You just shift this bit, one bit to the right, this one bit to the right, and this one bit to the right, and put this zero in this side. So you'll not get, you follow this this path in every problem. For cyclic codes, you will not get a wrong answer. It will be fine. What you are telling, it is correct. But this thing we are not doing here. So actually, in shifting, two type of shiftings are there. So I think I'll clear your doubt in the next class after reading this. Whatever you are telling, it might be right. But what I am telling you, just follow this.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so I have to go through this. What you are saying? Actually, I have also studied that, but I am not clear that what you are telling. So I'll get through it and I'll clear your answer. So this is all about cyclic codes. Now I will tell you the proper whatever things we are going to study in the cyclic codes. So basically, cyclic codes are divided into, so these things we are going to study. So first of all, how to generate the cyclic codes. So we have seen in the linear block codes also generation. So basically we call it as encoding. And second thing is detection. So how to detect? So we have done syndrome detection also in the linear block code. So it is similar to that only. So it is basically of two types, syndrome detection. And other one is syndrome calculator, how to calculate syndrome. So these all things we are going to cover in cyclic codes. This is your syllabus, and it is divided into non-systematic. So I have told you the difference between systematic and non-systematic. Non-systematic, and it is divided into systematic. And one more thing is there, cyclic encoder. And we can generate the non-systematic codes by two methods. One is multiplication, and other one is generator matrix. So we will see all those things, generator matrix. And for systematic also, I have to remove this. So is this clear? One more thing is left with systematic. So I have to tell about this. So systematic is divided into two parts. So one is division, and other one is generator matrix. So these all things we are going to study in the cyclic codes, and it is very interesting. You will find it very interesting. So basically it is divided into two part. One, how to generate this, how to encode this. Encode means we are going to transmit this cyclic code. Now we are going to detect this cyclic code, how these cyclic codes are getting detected. Is the code correct or not? Are we getting the correct code or not? And for generation, we can generate the cyclic code by three ways. In non-systematic, systematic, and cyclic encoder. So we have seen in linear block code also what is that non-systematic, what is systematic. Non-systematic can be generated in a two way, by multiplication method and by generator matrix method. Similarly, systematic can be generated in a two way, by division method and generator matrix method. By the same way, we can detect the cyclic code in a two way. Syndrome detection we have done in the linear block codes, and syndrome calculator, how to calculate the syndrome codes. So this is the syllabus for cyclic codes. So I think it will take couple of 1 weeks or 2 weeks. So we will cover this cyclic codes by 2 weeks. So now let's start with the non-systematic. So how to generate the non-systematic codes. So if you wanted to write, please write this. So we will cover all those things, and these are very interesting. You will enjoy it by doing the cyclic codes. And these cyclic codes are very important also. So, okay, before moving to the systematic, non-systematic, I have want to ask you, did you know how to calculate polynomial into codes? I mean, polynomial. So suppose one polynomial is given like this. If suppose I'll write it like this, x5, x cube plus x plus 1. So if I have to convert it into code, how to convert it into code? Did you know? Or if this is written like this, 1 0 1 1 0 1 0, so how to write in the polynomial? Is everyone is aware or straight? Tell it. So should I tell you how to convert this into polynomial, or you are already knowing? Because we will deal with the polynomial only. Tell.
No, sir.
We don't know. Okay, so I'll tell you. So first of all, I'll tell you how to convert these quotes into polynomial. So actually, this is very easy. So see, suppose if it is written like this, 1 0 1 1 0 1. So if it is written like this, so what I have to do? Okay, Komal and Kiran, you might be correct. I have to solve it. So suppose it is written like this, 1 0 1 1 0 1. So first count the bit. How many bits are there? 1 2 3 4 5 6. 6 bits are there. So you have to do 6 minus 1. So what you will get? 5. So you have to write here x to the power 5 into 1 into x to the power 5 plus 0 into x to the power 4 plus 1 into x to the power 3 plus 1 into x to the power 2 plus 0 into x plus 1. So whatever this numbers are written there, you have to just multiply with polynomial. Why I have written 5 here? Because total number of 6 bits are there. So I have subtracted 6 minus 1. So I'm getting here 5. So if you solve it, what you will get here? X to the power 5 plus this will become 0. So you will get here x to the power 3. This will become x to the power 2. This will become 0. So you will get here 1. So is this clear? I'll take one more problem for you. So then things will be more clear. So is this problem is clear? Are you getting it how I have done? If any problem is there, please ask me in between. Okay, so I'll take one more example for you. So things will be more clear. So let's suppose the problem is like this. Let's suppose the problem is like this, 0 0 0 1 0 1 1 1. So like this problem is there. So you just have to count how many bits are there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 are there. So what do you have to do? 8 minus 1, that is 7. So what we need to do? 0 into x to the power 7 plus 0 into x to the power 6 plus 0 into x to the power 5 plus 1 into x to the power 4 plus 0 into x to the power 3 plus 1 into x to the power 2 plus 1 into x plus 1. So when you will solve it, this will become 0, this will become 0, this will be 0. So what you will get here? X to the power 4 plus this will also become 0, x to the power 2 plus x plus 1. So now you will do how to convert the numbers into the bits into polynomial. Now you are
completed. Yes, sir.
Okay. So one more part I'm telling you to do. So let's start with like this. So let's suppose we have polynomial like this. This is x to the power 5 plus x to the power 3 plus x plus 1. So let's suppose it is given like this and you have to convert into bits. So how we have to convert into bits? X to the power 5 is there. So for x to the power 5, this is the biggest bit. Yeah, Vichal, you might be correct. I will solve here. So I'll write here 1. So x to the power 4 is not there. So for this, I'll write here 0. X to the power 3 is there. I'll write 1. X to the power 2 is not there. So I'll write 0. X is there. So I'll write 1. 1 is there. So I'll write 1. So similarly, I will solve one more problem for you. Suppose it is given as x to the power 6 plus x to the power 3 plus 1. So if somebody will ask you how to convert into the polynomial, so what we have to do? X to the power 6 is there. So I'll write here 1. 5 is not there. So I'll write here 0. 4 is not there. So I'll write 0. 3 is there. I'm writing here 1. 2 is not there, so I'll write 0. X to the power 1 is not there, so I'll write 0 and 1. So from directly from polynomial, we are converting to the bits. Earlier, I have shown you how we can convert bits into the polynomial. So is it clear? Can you do it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I think it is very simple. So we have to solve some more problem based on this. So I am telling you. So let's move to the multiplication method. Multiplication of non-systematic cyclic codes. So I should write the heading. What is that? Multiplication of non-systematic. So this is the first form of cyclic codes, non-systematic cyclic codes. So the problem will come like this. So if somebody will ask you, so the problem will be consider a 7,4 cyclic code with m equal to 1011 and gx equal to x to the power 3 plus x to the 1. And the problem will be like this: with the help of multiplication method, find the cyclic codes. So they are asking you to calculate cyclic codes. So don't, this is 1011. This is 1011. So this will be your problem. So I'll tell you the way how to solve it. So m means message bit. So message bit is given as, m is given as 1011. So we can convert this into the polynomial. So what will be the polynomial form for this 1011? So tell me, what should I write here?
x cube plus x plus 1.
So I've told you earlier, and gx is given as, generator matrix is given as x cube plus x plus 1. So you have to find the cx. So cx will be mx into gx. So you just needed to multiply this. So please multiply into your copy and pen and tell me what you are getting. So I'll tell you the final answer. So धीरे धीरे आगे बढ़ेंगे, पहले सिंपल प्रॉब्लम करेंगे, फिर थोड़ा कॉम्प्लिकेटेड बढ़ेंगे. तो मल्टीप्लिकेशन मेथड इज वेरी सिंपल. सो वन प्रॉब्लम विल कम फ्रॉम दिस साइड आल्सो इन योर पेपर, आरटीयू पेपर. सो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू डू एमएक्स इनटू जीएक्स. सो इन द प्रॉब्लम ओनली इट विल बी डिफाइंड, कि आपको प्रॉब्लम में डिफाइन किया रहेगा कि ये नॉन सिस्टमेटिक कोड से इसमें मल्टीप्लिकेशन मेथड लगाना है. और अगर प्रॉब्लम में लिखा रहेगा सिस्टमेटिक कोड, सो बाय सीइंग द प्रॉब्लम वी हैव टू अप्लाई डिवीजन मेथड. So because of that only I have drawn the flow charts. So if they are asking you that this is non-systematic cyclic codes, so you just have to do the multiplication method there. They will not ask you to apply multiplication method. You have to understand by your own. So let me do it. So cx equal to mx into gx. So multiply it. So what we are getting here? So x cube plus x plus 1 into x cube plus x plus 1. So this x cube will become x to the power 6 plus this x cube will become x to the power 4 plus this x cube will become x to the power 3. Now you have to multiply this x to the x cube. You will get here x to the power 4. Now this x to the, this you will get x to the power 2. Now this x to this, you will get here x. I think everybody is aware how to do multiply. So 1 into x cube will be x cube, and 1 into x will be x plus 1 into 1 will be 1. So is this clear? So now we have to write the similar terms together. So similar terms, 2x power, power 4 nahi hoga bichal. Just see how I'm doing it. So we have to write similar terms, means x to the power 6 एक साथ, फिर x4 एक साथ होगा, x4 प्लस x4 एक साथ, देन x to the power 3 एक साथ, x to the power 3 एक साथ, फिर x to the power 2, देन x एक साथ, x प्लस x एक साथ प्लस 1. सो जो भी नंबर दो बार आ रहा है वो जीरो हो जाएंगे, XOR ऑपरेशन हो जाएगा. मतलब 0 0 1 0 1 1 0, मतलब जो भी नंबर सेम है वो जीरो हो जाएंगे अपने आप. ये भी सेम है, ये भी जीरो हो जाएगा, ये भी सेम है, ये भी जीरो हो जाएगा. सो व्हाट आई कैन राइट हियर, x टू द पावर 6 प्लस x टू द पावर 2 प्लस 1. हां, सो नाउ आई हैव टू कन्वर्ट इट इनटू द बिट्स फॉर्म. सो फॉर x टू द पावर 6 आई विल राइट हियर 1 5 0 4 0 3 0 2 1 then 1 0, then 1. This will be your final answer for this multiplication method. So tell me if any doubt is there. So I'll try to solve one more time for you. If any doubt is there, how I have done this problem. So ultimately you have to represent it in the bit form. So this will be your final answer. So please tell me if any doubt is there.
No, sir.
Okay, so I think this multiplication method is very simple. Just you have to multiply these two bits, and whatever the similar bits will be there, you have to do the XOR operation between them. If you will do XOR operation between these two bits, it will be all 0. This two XOR operation will be 0 and this will be 0. So based on that, I have written here x to the power 6, x to the 2 plus 1. And this will be 100101. So we'll move to the one more problem. So I'm solving other problem, one more problem for you. So you have to solve it and you have to tell me the answer. So the question is like this. If m is given as 1011 and the polynomial is and gx is given as x to the power 4 plus x to the power 3 plus x plus 1. This is gx form and they are asking you to find the systematic codes for the cyclic codes. So please try to solve this and tell me the answer. So it will be more complicated. Let me do it in a simple way. So the complication, x to the power 3 plus x square plus 1. So this is the problem. So please try and solve this problem and tell me the answer. And this will be 01001. So it will be like this. The problem is, I think, 1001. So find this systematic cyclic codes. So tell me the final answer in the bit, what bit you are getting. Oh, Komal is what? Komal 111011. So Komal is getting 111011. So the Komal, check one more time. I think it is wrong. This will be not. Hemu is getting 100101. Hemu is getting 100101. Hemu, this is also wrong. 1100101. Suman is correct. So whoever is getting this answer, they are correct. Suman has given this answer. Subhanshu Yadav has given also this answer. So Subhanshu is also correct. Subhanshu is Pahlad, you have to check your answer. Avishal is also correct. 1100101. Komal Sharma 1100. Komal is also correct. Komal Sharma is correct. So Suman, Komal, Avichal, and Subhanshu has given me the correct answer. So this is the correct answer. 1100101. Yeah, Naman, this is the correct answer. 1100101. So Komal and Hemu, have you checked where you have processed the wrong, where you have done the wrong thing? Have you checked it?
Yes, sir.
So now you are getting the correct answer. What, double one, double? Okay, I did multiplication with 101. No, 1001. I have changed the question. 1001.
Yes, sir.
Okay, no problem. So
I have solved and afterwards we change the question.
Okay, so one more problem I'll give you for homework, and in the next session we will deal with the generator matrix. So one more problem is, so m is given as ट्रिपल
आपने जो पहले वाला m इक्वल्स टू 1011 दिया था उसमें 3 टाइम्स x^3 आ रहा था, तो उसमें कैसे करेंगे फिर?
नहीं समझा मैं, क्या दिया था प्रॉब्लम बोलो आप, मैं लिखता हूँ यहाँ पे।
पहले आपने दिया था m इक्वल्स टू 1011
m इक्वल टू क्या दिया था मैंने,
1011
हाँ, और gx क्या दिया था
सर? gx x^4 x^3 प्लस x प्लस 1
x^4 प्लस x^3
प्लस प्लस x प्लस 1
हाँ, तो क्या डाउट हो रहा है इसमें? डाउट क्या इसमें?
x की पावर अगर 3 टाइम अगर कोई चीज आए तो फिर उसमें कैसे करेंगे?
मतलब समझा नहीं, किसमें x की पावर 3 टाइम आ रही है?
इसको सॉल्व आउट करने के बाद
इसको क्या लिख सकते हैं हम, इसको क्या x की पावर 3 लिख सकते हैं इसको, और x की पावर यहाँ पे क्या होगा? हाँ बताइए आगे।
प्लस x प्लस 1
हाँ, और इसको मल्टीप्लाई किससे कर देंगे? x की पावर 4 प्लस x की पावर 3 प्लस x प्लस 1, तो क्या डाउट लग रहा है इसमें? मल्टीप्लाई कर
नहीं नहीं वो तो होगा, बट अगर कोई चीज अगर ऐसे 3 टाइम्स आ जाए तो 2 टाइम्स तो उसका 0 हो जाएगा, और 1 टाइम अगर कोई बच रहा हो तो फिर
3 टाइम्स 0 आ जाए, मतलब आप ये ऐसा बोल रही हैं ऐसा आ जाए?
3 टाइम अगर x की पावर 3 ऐसा कुछ भी टर्म आ जाए तो 2 टाइम्स तो उसका 0 हो जाएगा, पर 1 टाइम और बचेगा तो उसका क्या, तो वो भी 0 ही बन जाएगा कम्प्लीटली?
नहीं वो 0 नहीं बनेगा, फिर प्रॉब्लम गलत है।
ओके
हाँ, वो 0 नहीं बनेगा। जब 0 कब बनेगा? XOR ऑपरेशन में जब दोनों नंबर केवल 2 नंबर सेम होंगे तब बनेगा 0।
ओके सर,
तो प्रॉब्लम सही नहीं है। अगर प्रॉब्लम सही होगा तो सिर्फ 2 टाइम ही 0 बनेगा।
ओके ओके सर,
सो आई विल गिव वन होमवर्क प्रॉब्लम टू यू, सो सॉल्व इट एंड वी विल डिस्कस इट इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास एंड वी विल सी द जनरेटर मैट्रिक्स मेथड। So generator matrix will be more interesting. So it is very simple. Multiplication is very simple. I'll write the problem for you. 0001 and x cube plus x plus 1. And you have to solve cx. So we will solve it in the next class. It will be x square, I think. X square. So we'll solve this. And please try to solve it. Whatever homework I am giving. So please try to solve it. It is for your benefit only. So we will meet day after tomorrow. So actually I'm not feeling good, so I'll not take tomorrow's class. So we will meet day after tomorrow. So thank you everyone. Komal, please send me the attendance.
Sir,
हाँ बताइए
सर, लास्ट क्लास जो हुई थी ना सर, मुझे सर उसमें क्वेश्चन में डाउट आया, तो सर क्लियर कर दोगे?
हाँ बिल्कुल कर देंगे, आप क्वेश्चन व्हाट्सएप कर देना मुझे, क्या डाउट है लिख के भेज देना।
हाँ सर,
जो भी आपको डाउट है क्वेश्चन लिख के भेज दीजिएगा और व्हाट्सएप कर दीजिएगा मुझे।
ओके
ओके,
तो आप पूरा सर कंप्लीटली एक क्वेश्चन वो सॉल्व करा के बता देते तो सर यही डाउट क्लियर हो जाता।
पूरा क्वेश्चन तुम वीडियो देखो फिर बताओ कहाँ डाउट हो रहा है।
हाँ सर, वीडियो देखा था मैंने, वो तो
उसके पहले था, उसके पहले का वीडियो देखो एक बार आप, उसके पहले आप
सारी देखी मैंने,
अंडरलाइन करके भेज देना मुझे, मैं बता दूंगा कहाँ गलत है। आप अपना जो सलूशन है वो लिख के भेज देना, मैं आपको बता दूंगा यहाँ स्टेप में गलत है। आप पहले खुद तो लगाओ, मैं यहाँ पे लगा दूंगा फिर आपको कुछ नहीं मिलेगा ना, मैं आपका एफर्ट देखना चाहता हूँ, आप क्या कर रहे हो। आप लगा के भेजो, जो भी स्टेप होगा मैं बता दूंगा आपको ये स्टेप गलत है।
ओके सर ठीक
है, सो थैंक यू एवरीवन, विल मीट डे आफ्टर टुमारो, सो कोमल विल सेंड मी द अटेंडेंस, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट टुडे। थैंक यू ऐश्वर्या।